Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. Thank you for joining us today at the Game Accessibility Conference for a showcase of our colorblindness accessibility tool called Chroma. I'm Jawad Shakil and I'm honored to present at GA Conference today as a product manager of Chroma at Ubisoft. We at Ubisoft are thrilled to share this tool with everyone, which we hope will empower more people to make games or digital content which are accessible to colorblind players. So let's dive in and explore how this tool can be easily integrated in your workflow, allowing you to create and test faster. Did you know that globally around 300 million people are estimated to have colorblindness, which is roughly equivalent to the population of the United States? This emphasizes the importance of making our digital content accessible to everyone regardless of their ability to perceive color. Now, coming to the challenges that we faced, in our journey to make our games more accessible, we established a dedicated team to help test accessibility features. This incredible team, known as the Worldwide QC Accessibility Team, is based in our Bucharest studio. The accessibility team encountered three important challenges while assessing the accessibility of our games for colorblind players. The first one being ensuring the simulation was accurate. The second one being allowing us to view the simulation in real time and without missing frame. The third and the last one being our test team were not able to control the game while simulation was active. To give you a better idea of the challenges we faced before Chroma, our test team's workflow required them to take screenshots of high priority areas within the game and then apply a colorblindness filter over it to assess it for issues. Also, there was no real-time feedback of what the test team were testing, making it tedious and inefficient for the team as the test team had to go back and forth after taking the screenshot from the game. These challenges led us to develop a new tool called Chroma. Chroma is a colorblindness simulator designed for everyone. It empowers developers and testers to ensure their applications and games are accessible to individuals with colorblindness. I will now delve into how we overcame the challenges we were facing one by one. The first challenge for us to address was accuracy of the algorithm. Chroma is powered by the highly accurate Color Oracle algorithm, offering robust colorblindness simulation for all types. We have conducted multiple tests over an extended period to identify the algorithm that could simulate colorblindness filters most accurately. Through intensive testing with different algorithms, we found that the Color Oracle algorithm consistently topped our benchmarking charts and closely matched real-world conditions. The second challenge was that the tool needed to simulate in real-time. Chroma simulates the selected application in real-time with an overlay, ensuring that no frames are missed and eliminating the need to process static images. In contrast, other applications in the market require manual overlay placement over the game. This manual process was tedious and carried a high risk of losing frames or having the frames change completely by the time the overlay was added. Due to the dynamic nature of the game, this often required redoing the test steps and recreating the same scenarios. The last challenge to address was the ability to be able to interact with the game while simulating colorblindness. With Chroma, users can interact with the application while the simulation overlay is running, ensuring a seamless testing experience without the need to switch back and forth between multiple applications. This real-time overlay maintains testing continuity and quality, addressing the challenges posed by non-real-time tools. Previously, the lack of real-time simulation caused issues with the continuity of the test, as we had to constantly switch between tools when assessing the game for colorblindness. Chroma's real-time overlay has significantly improved our testing process by maintaining consistency and quality. Chroma comes packed with features to enhance usability and accessibility. Chroma offers flexible screen options to suit your needs. Chroma can be utilized on either dual or single screens, versatile for different setups. Users can operate Chroma by using assignable hotkeys. It also provides dual view screenshot capturing, which merges both the original and altered app states in a single image. Users can also customize overlay based on their requirements by dragging the borders of Chroma UI in either of the directions. Let's now get into how the tool works exactly. To set up Chroma, we begin by first downloading the Chroma installer from the Ubisoft GitHub repository. Next, we double-click on the installer and follow the guided steps displayed to install Chroma. We'll create a shortcut on desktop for our ease of access. Now to initiate Chroma, we double-click on the Chroma icon. We should see the Chroma GUI open. Now that we have the tool installed and running, let's take a tour of the Chroma UI. To begin the configuration, we will first need to have the Chroma GUI on screen. Then we need to select the application that we want to simulate through Chroma. To simulate the desired application, we need to right-click on the Chroma UI area and select the application we want to simulate. You should see the Chroma overlay mirroring your application. Now we go to the taskbar, click on Show Hidden Icons, and right-click on the Chroma icon. The tool options will open. The options menu will have the following settings for the user. The first setting being Filter. This setting is used to change the colorblindness simulation filter manually. The second setting is Input. This setting allows user to swap the control between tool and the application while the overlay is active. The third setting allows the user to maximize or minimize the Chroma UI. The fourth setting is the option setting. This menu is where the user is able to configure the different hotkeys to change filter, take screenshots on the go. It also has the option for the user to change the output directory. These are all the UI elements we need to be able to configure and work with Chroma. Now, we will begin by navigating to the options menu in the Chroma settings. Once we have the options menu open, we'll begin by assigning the hotkeys for each family of functions in Chroma. We'll begin by assigning a hotkey for tool or game mode. We assign it as a combination of Alt key plus 9. Next, we assign the hotkey for both the variants of the screenshot. We assign Control plus K for screenshot that consists of only simulated screen and Control plus L for the screenshot that consists of both the simulated and the original screen in one image. Next, we assign the hotkey for each of the filters. We assign Shift plus I as a hotkey for default or no filter, Shift plus O for protanopia, Shift plus P for deuteranopia, Shift plus K for tritanopia, and Shift plus L for grayscale. Lastly, we change the output repository as per our requirements. We are all set with our configurations. Now let's check how do we configure Chroma for dual screen and single screen mode. In dual screen mode configuration, to begin, you first need to select the application you want to simulate by right-clicking on the Chroma UI area. In dual screen mode, the application you are simulating can be simulated in full screen, where Chroma is running on one screen and on the other screen you have the application running. You can resize the simulation screen by dragging the UI borders of Chroma in the desired direction. That's all we need to do for the dual screen mode configuration. In single screen mode configuration, we begin again by selecting the application we want to simulate by right-clicking on the Chroma UI. In single screen mode, you need to run full screen applications such as games in windowed mode. Otherwise, Chroma won't be able to simulate the application. This is the main difference between the screen configurations. In single screen, you need the application to be in the windowed mode, and in dual screen, you can simulate the whole screen using Chroma. Once the overlay is activated, we can resize the overlay by dragging the borders to cover the whole window of the application or parts of it as per our requirements. Now, we may notice that the application and simulated screens are misaligned. To align them, all we need to do is use the arrow keys to realign the screen, where overlay mouse completely covers the mouse icon on the application screen. That is all that is required for single screen configuration. Now that we have configured Chroma, let's see Chroma in action. Once we are done with our configuration, we will press the hotkey to change from tool mode to game mode. This feature allows us to control the game or application even when the overlay is active. It's particularly useful in a single screen setup. Now that we are in game mode, we can switch to our first filter. Using the hotkey, we should be able to change the filter from default to Protanopia. Here, you may see that the shades of red are missing. Next, we switch to Deuteranopia. Here, we will see the shades of green missing. Now we can switch to Tritanopia. Here, we will see the shades of blue missing. The last one is the grayscale filter, where everything is black and white. This easy switch between filters allows our teams to have continuity in their tests and much better efficiency when it comes to coverage and time taken to test the games. In the same way, we can use the hotkeys to change between different filters on the dual screen setup. Nothing here changes. Everything remains the same, apart from the application being in full screen mode in dual screen configuration. We can now proceed to take screenshots as and when we require. To be able to capture the issues that our teams find during the test, they can use the screenshot hotkey Control K or L to take the screenshot. We can find all our screenshots in the repository that we had configured earlier. In this case, it's on desktop. They can take the screenshot in two variations. One, which only contains the simulated screen, and the other screenshot that contains both the original and simulated screen side by side. And that's it. Chroma is a user-friendly tool that's easy to configure and use. We are releasing Chroma as an open source tool to empower everyone in making content accessible. We invite you to use it, contribute to it, and help improve it continuously. Accessibility is a collective effort, and we believe in the power of community collaboration. Whether you're a seasoned developer or just starting out, you can contribute to Chroma by submitting the code improvements, adding new features or integrations, reporting bugs or suggesting enhancements. You don't need to be a developer to make a difference. Help us by using the tool and providing feedback, sharing your experiences and use cases with us, and also spreading the word about Chroma to your network. Before we move on, I would like to take a moment to recognize the people behind the development of Chroma. The team whose effort and commitment have made this a valuable solution for all of us. Join us in making the games accessible. Scan the QR code to redirect to the Ubisoft GitHub repository. Additionally, you can visit the official Ubisoft GitHub link displayed on the screen to access the Chroma source code and GUI application. To learn more about the Color Oracle algorithm that powers Chroma, please visit colororacle.org. Thank you for your time and attention. We hope you share our excitement about Chroma and its potential to transform accessibility in games and applications. Together, we can make digital experiences accessible for everyone. Have a great day ahead.